And we're live. The Gamers Just Duo podcast number 30 caught Eric drinking, literally. I was like, should I give him a warning? And I just waited for it. I waited until everything was quiet.
Because you were quiet.
Yeah. Oh, man, dude, you figured me out. I got to basically be in mid-conversation and then just be like, welcome. Just cut myself off.
Just be like talking normal.
Hey, man, these tacos are welcome. Really, welcome to the... Yeah, so we are the world's number one entertainment podcast. That's not true at all. We are an entertainment podcast that talk mostly about video games, movies, TV, superhero stuff, Destiny, PlayStation. This is where our interests lie. If your interests connect, then you should stick around because we might connect. You know what I'm saying? Gosh, dang it, dude.
Number one podcast in America.
Number one podcast in Puerto Rico.
It reminds me of like when you see like a movie poster and it's like number one movie in America.
Yeah. It's like what? It's like just box quotes. Tons of fun. IGN. Oh man, so
it's not a girl.
It's not a girl. I wish that could be our thumbnail.
It's not a man. That's what it was.
Yeah, it's not a man. I wish that could be our thumbnail. It's just big, bold letters. It's not a man. Anyways. Yeah, so I'm one of your hosts, TBSAC, but you can call me Teddy. And as you most likely know, maybe not, if you're new, This over here is Eric.
Hello.
Otherwise known
as Legend BVM.
Yeah. Oh, finishing it off. You're like, we're so close there, we can finish each other's sentences. It's adorable.
Oh, yeah, you can add me on Twitter and RuneScape at LegendPVM.
Gotta get that RuneScape money.
RuneScape plug, yeah.
Gosh, dang. Did you resub to RuneScape?
No, not yet.
Okay, not yet. But you're thinking about it.
I'm thinking about it.
All right, well, yeah, so normally we go over what we've been playing throughout the week and, you know, we just give a general update and then we go through the nerd culture updates. We actually have a crap ton of stuff to get through. Probably equal to the post E3 show.
Yeah.
Because we were gone for a week because last week I had to move downstairs because my AC broke up here and there were like people entering my room all the time. And yeah, so yeah, we're just going to give a general update as what's been going on the last 2 weeks because we weren't here. So yeah, I was down there. Eric was sick this day last week. So he was like, I could do it. But I was like, nah, it's fine. We can just wait a week. There won't be anything big happening or anything.
Yeah.
Freaking San Diego Comic Con and other stuff.
So I
just moved. I finished moving up here like 30 minutes ago. So I'm back in my room. Also, people watching the video version. Also, I don't normally wear gunners when I do this, but I was. Because the light like reflects off the screen, off the glasses. The light of the screen. Wow. Nate is playing Rocket League.
What?
He bought Rocket League on PC. Just tossing that out there. Nate.
Oh.
I just saw him open it, and I sent him two messages in all caps that said, what? Free
it's
on PS
free
Plus.
On PS.
And that's all I said. Anyway. gosh,
oh my
that.
Gosh.
That killed me.
That's horrible. It's like the same
also,
performance, too.
I think that Rocket League is cross-platform, dude.
It is, yeah.
That's so cool.
You can
cool.
play with Nate.
That's so cool. I love when games do that. That's the best. So yeah, for people watching the video version, I'm gonna do a quick duck so you can see those. Look at that crap! I got a DC poster. These are all framed. I got a DC poster, New 52. I got an Avatar The Last Airbender poster. And I got a Destiny poster. And they look so good!
I need poster frames.
I've wanted to get those up for so long. And is that the Star Wars
one
with
one.
Like
really
all
good.
The characters? Yeah.
All the characters, ships and vehicles, anything.
I had one similar to that, but it was just all the characters and it was just like, you know, their heads like shoulders up and they were all like stacked like a landscape like this and it was just all the important characters. It's crazy. I like just kept staring at it and being like,
You see something new every time you look at it.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. It's crazy.
Because there's a bunch of people in the background.
The funny thing about this one, though, is that right about here is a little Anakin from Phantom Menace. And then right behind him is Darth Vader. Which is kind
of that doesn't weird. Make much sense at all.
Yeah, and but there's no like regular Anakin beside Obi-Wan over here, so I don't know.
That's very odd. Weird.
Anakin's in there twice.
Nate responded to my message and said, "What?" question mark, and I said, "Rocket League is free for PS Plus users, dude," which you most likely are.
Rip.
So yeah, we got posters. They're pretty cool. I'm sure you audio listeners really appreciate this talk about these posters.
Oh, yeah.
But they're, just imagine it in your head. They're really cool.
Star Wars. Just imagine all the Star Wars characters and Avatar.
Yeah. Aang looking like a boss. Yeah. The Destiny
well,
cover.
I can't see it, so I feel for you guys.
You saw it earlier, though. Yeah. But, yeah. Update. Eric is sick again. He was better.
Yeah.
And then it hit him today.
I'm right now. I broke my fever. For now, I'm probably feel horrible in the morning. I'm probably gonna go to the doctor and miss work.
Yeah.
So that's great. Yeah. That's a thing. Earlier, I was bedridden, moaning and groaning and dying. So yeah.
Let's move on through this, mate.
Podcast.
Yep. I'm sorry, that was so funny to me. But, podcast, so. That's, like, the worst thing of, like, what do I say now? Podcast. We're doing one of those right now.
We should talk about what some of the things we've been playing.
We actually have a lot
to talk about because of a certain MMO.
Okay. Yeah, sure. Do you want to start there?
Why not?
YOLO. So, yeah, I just said that. So, last night, Eric's been telling me about this game, and the whole world has been telling me about this game.
You told me about the game, so.
Oh, well, yeah. It's called Skyforge, and it's a new MMO that's been getting a ton of buzz from the people that like MMOs that I follow on Twitter and YouTube and Twitch and all that. So I've been seeing a lot about it, and I went to play it, and it's really cool.
It's really unique approach on it, because it's not like the usual go get a quest, do this, do that. You get, of course, beginning, we're at the beginning, so a lot of training and stuff, but you have, like, a hub that you're at, and you fly around and teleport at this.
I was about to say, do you fly around?
You teleport when you go to missions and stuff, but it's like a hub, and there's also, like, a built-in LFG, built-in matchmaking for when you do missions, which is really cool.
Yeah. It's really unique. It's got a lot of different aspects. It's got like a combo action
really cool.
based
yeah.
combat. And then
the only class that I've seen who has combos is the Paladin so far.
I'm pretty sure everyone has combos.
Nope.
Really?
The other two don't. I've used all three.
What does it have when you go to that one menu where it shows your combos on, on Paladins where it has that
little... I didn't take
a
better look at that, but I think there's for the Cryomancer, it's just like a charge attack.
Interesting. That's really freaking weird. You can switch classes at any time, and then the other really interesting feature, I only played like an hour, and that was it, but this is what I got from an hour. And then the other really cool feature is that there's no traditional, like, 1, 2, 3 leveling system.
It's a prestige.
Yeah, which you, like, get from progression and your gear.
It's a gear level.
So, it's really cool. I'm a big fan of that.
Yeah, I like that, because if you need to, like, bump down a few prestige to play with some other, like, lower levels if you want, you can do that.
But it's an open beta, and it's set to come out later this year. So, also, I've been playing... Let's see. I've been
playing...
Played
some Halo.
I'm playing a lot of stuff. Yeah, I played some Halo. I got really lost on the flood mission, and it was something.
I hate that mission, honestly.
Yeah, I'm excited to get through and actually, like, you know, continue where things aren't awful, because that was just not good. Oh!
The library is worse, but...
Gosh, freaking dang it.
It's all flood, and it's scary, and you run out of ammo. So, but you're... it's a cool mission because you're looking for the index. So because the monitor 343 Guilty Spark wants to use the Halo, which destroys all life in the universe.
Well, that just doesn't sound like a smart thing to do, then, does it?
Yep.
But yeah, I played a little bit of Halo Combat Evolved.
Good game.
Been playing a crap ton of Rocket League, which came out last week and was free for PlayStation Plus users. I don't remember. Did we went over PlayStation Plus things at the... No, we didn't for the E3 one. Because it was too... It was... Yeah, no.
Oh, yeah.
So we'll go... I'll, you know, I'll do this... No, I'll just... We'll do it in a minute after what we've been playing. We've been playing a ton of Rocket League. Rocket League is freaking awesome. Playing a bunch of Destiny because our friends Gabby and Jared got a PS4, so we've been carrying them. It's been a lot of fun there. Oh man, we had so much fun playing Minecraft when it was Eric, Ryan, and Andrew.
Ryan had to go to Hawaii.
Yeah, Ryan's out of town for like a week and a half, so we're like,
Hawaii? Who goes to Hawaii?
it's overrated.
I'm gonna send him the time sent for this exact spot. And I'm just going to laugh right now. Let's laugh at him right now.
Ha, 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 ha. Gosh, dang it. Yeah. That was something. So, yeah, we spent, like, one night just going ham. We're going to freaking beat the Ender Dragon. It's going to be awesome.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah, when Ryan gets back, we're going to be playing a ton of this. I'm going to be streaming all this crap. It's going to be great. Yeah, that's mostly what I've been playing. Every now and then I'll jump on and do a tiny bit of the side missions in Batman, because I still want to do that. I'm honestly, ever since playing with Gabby and Jared, it's made me want to get back into Destiny. As you guys know, we're big into Destiny, but we were obviously for about a month just taking a break and like playing other games for this summer, because honestly, House of Wolves did not do a great job as to replayability, but like, at the same time, we play that game a ton, so it's good to like have a break. So yeah. I was very happy with that break, and I probably still will play a bunch of other games, but I legitimately want to get on and run Skolas and do bounties.
Well, we still only run Skolas with Andrew.
Yeah, and Skolas was the last time we did Skolas was pre-nerf, so he should be better.
Should be easier. Yeah.
Well, so yeah.
Better.
Yeah, better. So I'm totally. I really want to get back into that. But that's mostly what I played. What did you play, Eric?
Oh.
Other than you know those.
I played a lot of Trove.
Yeah.
I saw.
Oh, we did that too. I played a little bit of Trove.
Yeah, we played some Trove.
We played a lot because it's been.
It
2 weeks.
Is. It is a good game.
Yeah, Trove is dope.
It does need a little bit more customization in terms of, I don't know. I haven't gotten too deep into the building, though. But in terms of, there's a few customizations that options I wish that was in the game. But otherwise, it's a really cool game. And, I think it has fishing, right?
From what I heard,
I hadn't done it yet.
See, yeah, Trove is awesome.
It has, like, a bunch of features I wish a lot of MMOs had, too.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. There's, like, a giant mosquito eater thing in my room. Oh, frick. He's, like, hovering over this light. But I can't, like, reach out and grab him. One, because I'm not a ninja. Two, because he's, like, huge, and I don't want to do that. But, frick, he's gone!
He's gone.
Oh, no. Oh, what a nightmare. All right. But, what a nightmare. Yeah, so, I mean, it's been a long time. That's mostly what we've been playing and what we can remember. It's been a while. But I
Rocket
wanted to...
League.
Yeah, Rocket League.
Lots of Rocket League.
Been playing a lot of Rocket League. But I wanted to... Oh, crap, Eric. Nothing's going on here. There we go. I wanted to talk to... I wanted to update people as to some of the games that I want to play and stream on Xbox. Freaking, you know, Halo the Master Chief Collection. I really want to play Dead Rising 3. By the way, oh, you guys don't even know about this? Because I had just gotten my Xbox on the last podcast, and I was just talking about it. So, me and my brother-in-law did the thing that is apparently a thing that you can do, where he set his Xbox as my home Xbox, and I set my Xbox as his home Xbox, so we both share games now. Like, if I buy a game, he gets it. If he buys a game, I get it. So, today, as an example, using Facebook's new, you know, sending money feature, which is pretty dang awesome, he sent me $15 for a $30 game, and I bought it, and we're both going to play it, and it's cool. So, I have Halo the Master Chief Collection. I want to play it. I want to play Dead Rising 3. I want to play a little bit of Idarb. This Massive Chalice is apparently really good from what I've been hearing. Smite. I downloaded Project Spark because I had heard about that for like 2 years now, and I was just like, it's here. I'm going to freaking download it.
I should actually have my Xbox by next Monday. Next week sometime.
Hopefully. Sunset Overdrive, because I really want to freaking play that game. And the game that I bought today with Clayton was State of Decay, Year One Survival Edition. And you will totally see me stream that, because...
Nice, good streaming game.
Yeah, I want to play that. So, turning off the Xbox.
I will say that I played Dead Rising 1, and it was like the best thing ever, because you can just do the craziest stuff. I mean, you can in Dead Rising 2, but the problem with Dead Rising 2 is that you have a timer.
Yeah, I heard
all the time.
I heard that and, 3 was really good, was really great.
And I haven't
really
heard much about
it.
3.
Clayton really liked 3 when we were playing, when it was like an Xbox One launch title, so he was a big fan of that. He was playing that a lot. It apparently, like, always has a zombie counter of, like, how many zombies he's killed. Like, just always.
Yeah.
So, that's really cool. One thing that interests me that won't apply to me because I don't have the Kinect, but one thing that I thought was cool was that it had actual, like, cool Kinect features. As in, like, in certain places, you cannot be loud. Like, in certain places, you have to, like, if you're loud, it'll alert the zombies nearby, which is really cool.
In Dead Rising 1, you could have, like, a golf club, and, your character would set down the golf balls and just smack them into the, or he would drive the balls into the zombie's head, and he'd go,
wah, driving those wah. Balls, you know what I'm saying?
So, yeah, the game was ridiculous, but,
oh my god,
the second one sucked, because you had to get medicine to your daughter, like, every...
Yeah.
And it's
worse. So, yeah, that's what we've been playing in the past week. One quick thing. Normally we don't go we do that later in the show. We used to do that later in the show when we actually have shows that we've been watching. We would go over what we've been watching. But we don't have those because no shows are going on right now.
Actually, hold on.
I'm watching shows, but they're not going on as in airing. But
how long ago was our last podcast?
Post E3. The post E3 show where we talked.
Oh, okay. Well, then I can say that I played Subnautica, and that's a really good game.
I think you talked about that
though
last time.
I think I talked about that actually, but it's a good game. I still been playing it so.
Yeah. Cool. So, but we don't normally talk about what we've been watching until later. But I want to throw this out there. Hunt the Truth is so freaking good.
See,
even if you're not a Halo fan, download that and listen to that because it's amazing.
It's so good.
That is all.
The voice acting is so good. And just wait till you hear the last few episodes.
Episode 9 killed me, dude. It killed me.
Oh,
I was like, this is so good. So I'm
you need
excited.
To like listen to that after we finish here because Travis Willingham did so good.
I got stuff to do. I'm gonna sit down, maybe I'm gonna read some comics.
Travis Willingham, mate.
Watch some more Girl Meets World. Quick shout out to Girl Meets World, by the way. Season 2 is really good. Just wanna toss that out there. Moving on. Just saying.
Markiplier played Rocket League. There we go.
Everyone's playing Rocket League.
The game
Everyone's
wins.
Winning. Everyone's playing Rocket League, dude. It's I don't know. I'm happy at how well they're doing because it's a really good game. So, moving on. We're done with what we've been playing. Let's talk about a lot of freaking news. Lots of gaming news. First, you remember this little game called Cube World, Eric? Do you remember this? Do you remember that there were two people developing it, a guy and his wife, and they hadn't the guy had not tweeted out anything since like last year?
Yeah, well, I...
Yeah, and we have seen nothing about the game until apparently a guy at Kotaku reached out to him. And
I was like, Wally, where are you?
Yeah,
are
you and alive? And he actually responded. Yeah. So he basically was like, he basically was like that he's had to scrap and redo the quest system multiple times, but he says that it's coming, it's getting close, and once the quest system is done, everything else will be like a breeze. So I don't know. Cube World's not totally dead. That's good news. It's so weird to me. The guy just went silent for a year, and he's still working on the game.
He posted, like, a video. He posts, like, some videos once in a while.
Not since a year ago, though. He used to do that. And then his last video was the questing video, which was his last tweet about the questing video. And then it was gone. And then he was done for a year, which is very weird. But, yeah, Cube World is not dead. But in the meantime, play Trove because it's really cool and is actually supported. Just tossing that out there.
Thing. Wasn't it just him and his, like, wife or something?
It was him and his wife. Yeah. That was those are the only two people working on that game. So
incredible for...
Yeah, it's really impressive. But, you know, at some point, you gotta just get some more people.
Like, come on. They should have enough money now.
Yeah, that's my whole...
Hire, like, a third or fourth person.
That is my whole deal with why I really dislike Dean Hall, the creator of DayZ, because he took all the money and did not invest it back into his game. He made so much money. But what's... I don't know. The only thing is, like, I don't know, do whatever you want with your money, but, like, if people invest in an early access product, you would expect it to be a finished good product. That's what kills me. He had been working on it for forever, and he didn't invest, like, pretty much anything. If he had invested some and made the company, you know, like, bigger than, like, you know, 12 people, then that'd be okay. Make it, like, 30, and then you're good to go to make a really good AAA
cigars from Jamaica or something.
But yeah, anyways, moving on from Dean Hall. Oh, by the way, I still haven't finished watching the Microsoft conference. I'm still slowly making my way through that. But I watched a minute of it, and Dean Hall, the creator of DayZ, is, like, making an Ion game. Well, a game called Ion. And I don't know fully what it is, but it's, like, spacey. And what's funny, what kills me. This is another reason why I don't like him. They freaking come at me, Dean Hall. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. But, just in general, I don't fully get it. I'm sure maybe he has a logical reason as to why he didn't invest back into the game, but I don't know. Or maybe he did, and I'm just uninformed.
Yeah.
But they were showing off, before he came out on stage, they were showing off Xbox's new, like, early access program, which is a thing now that they're gonna, like, support on Xbox. And then he comes out, and he's like, my game, Ion, has been a prototype for years, is going to be available on Xbox One and PC on the Early Access program. And I'm like, again? Again with the Early Access, Steve?
You already have a game as broken.
Well, he doesn't work for them anymore. But, still, go back and finish it. Anyways, so, another bit of, not bit of news, but... this is something that I forgot to mention that I had been playing. The Batgirl DLC came out the other day, and I played it. A tiny bit lackluster, but pretty good. Pretty good.
See,
I don't know.
It's funny because
everyone else is crapping on it, but I thought it was all right.
Yeah,
that's all I gotta say.
I've played as Batgirl once in game. So
what? Where?
That's how early I'm in the game.
You don't play as Batgirl in the main story.
I do.
I'm almost positive you don't.
Yeah, when you're trying to save her, you can switch to her and play as her during that whole scene.
When you're trying to save... But she's an...
Catwoman, sorry.
Okay, there we go. That makes more sense. Sorry. I was like, Batgirl's paralyzed in the main story.
I'm just like
she's
thinking,
Oracle. I was like, do you just like do a dual team takedown with her wheelchair? I don't get how that works.
Oh gosh. Anyway.
So
you see my point.
Yeah.
But
so what do you want to talk about when it comes to news? What tickles your peach?
Tickles my peach.
Yep, what tickles your peach? There's something on here that you're actually really interested in, but you haven't seen it yet. That's my guess.
Oh, Halo?
You can tell that Eric does a ton of preparation for these podcasts.
Yes. Especially when I'm sick.
Yeah, that's reasonable. That's an excuse.
Okay, what's this? Halo Fall of Reach getting an animated movie adaptation to ship with Halo 5. Interesting. I've not heard of this yet. I knew there was like an some sort of series coming out.
No. Okay. So Halo the Fall of Reach was a book. It was a Halo book.
Yes.
And it's getting an animated adaptation, I would assume movie, but I'm pretty sure movie. And it's coming like it's shipping with Halo 5. So that's
awesome
pretty
because,
dope because Halo the Fall of Reach is apparently really cool from what I've heard.
It's well Halo Reach.
Well it's called the Fall of Reach, mate. The book at least. You're like, get out of here.
Yeah here.
Yes, get out of here.
Yeah here. Yeah here. yeah, Halo Reach was about a Noble team and you play as Noble Six. And
does the book have much to do with the actual
Noble
like
team?
Reach?
It's
from Halo the Fall of Reach, the book.
Yes.
I said it a couple of times. I'm saying
it's a planet.
I know. I'm saying does the game have much to do with the book as in story wise?
Yeah, I don't know about that, but I know that it's about the same thing. It's about the Fall of Reach. So.
Interesting. I don't know.
You get to go on Reach and you save the universe and dies. Everyone dies.
Oh, well, that's, you didn't do your job well enough then. You did not do your job well enough. Oh, okay. All right. To your audio listeners, Eric just went, and then like,
because I thought about the ending. I was like,
oh my gosh, does everyone actually gosh dang it, you could have, that's your generic spoiler like joke, that's your generic spoiler joke, and in this case you screwed it by being, oh my goodness, we're just gonna ignore that, move on.
Not everyone died. What am I thinking?
Eric's sick if you haven't noticed.
Because they're freaking Spartans. Spartans don't die sometimes.
But sometimes. Yeah, Eric's sick. And the whole Halo storyline is a bit big and complicated. So we're just going to move on from that for now. So out of all that weirdness, I just want to take a second and just sum it down.
Question. Will you eventually be able to play Halo Reach on your Xbox One?
I do not think so. Other than backwards compatibility.
Yeah.
Probably.
Sweet.
So, I want to take a quick moment to get a little serious here and talk about a bit of sad news that happened last week. The president and CEO, I don't know about president, but the CEO of Nintendo passed away, Satoru Iwata. Satoru Iwata. And he is a guy who had worked at the company for like years. Like he started way back in like the Super Nintendo days, I'm pretty sure. And like worked his way up through the ranks of the company to eventually just be the CEO, which is really cool. I heard that he was apparently one of the One of the, I think he was the first CEO that was not like a family of the previous people. Like the previous Nintendo CEOs had all been like family of the others, of the previous one. Like it had been like, you know, like a royalty thing. And he was like the first to actually not be part of that. So that's really cool, breaking into that.
Yeah.
But I don't know, man. It's sad because he was only 55 years old. And
like, didn't he die from...
Yeah, it was like cancer.
Some sort of cancer, yeah.
Yeah. So, he died at 55 from cancer. I'm not exactly sure what type, but... it's sad, because 55, like, I heard that he had died, and I didn't know too much about him before this, and I was like, I kind of just assumed that he was an older, like, older gentleman. I don't know. I figured he might have been, like, old age or something. But...
Dude, Asians all look very young. So.
That's a good point. But so 55, it's quite young and pretty sad. But I don't know. He has had the gaming industry would look a lot different without him.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Like, even if I didn't, you know, play the games that he produced on the Super Nintendo because I was not born. The place that we're at now would be a lot different if games weren't influenced by the games that he helped produce.
I don't think if like back in what was like the 80s or 90s, there was like that gaming crash that was happening. I feel like if that didn't go too well, it would be a lot different. And I feel like Nintendo was a big part of keeping the gaming industry alive.
Yeah.
Back in those days, so. Especially, well, for me at least, I didn't know this guy, Satoru, until the news of him dying. Yeah. But apparently he worked on Earthbound, which is like a fan favorite of a bunch of people.
Yeah, he had his hand on a ton of games. Like, but I think Earthbound was one of the ones that he produced.
He helped produce it, apparently, and a lot of people... enjoyed it because it was like about to go out of, it wasn't like it was about to like completely not be able or published words. Yeah,
he was also apparently really good at programming.
Oh yeah,
he was like a programming legend. Like he got certain games that were just not working to just work, and then they got to ship it because of that, which is really cool.
I think he had a hand in part of Super Mario World,
which is
my favorite, my first video game, and one of my favorite. Classics.
Yeah, I don't fully know the extent of like which games he had a hand in, which he didn't, but a lot of the early games I would assume, not you know like all of them or but a decent amount I would assume.
And I would assume like earlier games he had more of a hand in because they were a smaller company back then.
And what's cool is that like now as they've gotten bigger, he's still like he still had a hand in like the new Star Fox that's coming out.
Yeah.
Like, so he's just continued, like, not just being, like, the CEO of Nintendo, but he's still continued, like, producing games.
A developer and a gamer.
Yeah. So.
And the president.
Hats off to all that he accomplished through his life. And how it changed the industry and where we're at today.
Before. In the past, like, few years, there's been this whole thing with the Wii U. People ragging on it. I wonder what whoever's taking his spot is gonna do in terms of all of those complaints. I mean, there's been complaints about you know how Nintendo doesn't like copyrighted stuff on YouTube or something like that.
Well, Nintendo's just a weird company in general. They have the copyrighted stuff on YouTube. They have the no third-party support. They have weird hardware. Like,
I just wonder if there's gonna be some changes.
I don't think. I think there might be slight changes, but I think that the whole uniqueness of the unique mindset of Nintendo, I think, runs deep in that company.
Mm.
Like every Nintendo Direct, is not every, but I saw one that was like. We strive to be a unique, different place, you know, for gamers. So, I don't know.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so hats off to him, and we will move on to happier news. Right. So, going straight in, Batman v Superman, San Diego Comic-Con. Let's go. We're watching the trailer right now.
I don't have one.
I'm fine today. I don't have one either. Think I come prepared to this thing?
Maybe.
So, the air conditioner in this room was fixed, but by fixed, they mean not totally fixed. Like, it's not 90 degrees up here, but it won't go below 75. And I like to keep my air at 72, so I have, like, a slight humidity to myself. You know what I mean? Like, a slight little bit of sweat. Not enough to be, like, a sweat bead, but, like, just, oh, it's the worst. It's so bad. I'm going to get, when we finish this podcast, I'm going to go... like, stand under a really high-powered fan for a minute and just be like, all right. And then come back. But here's the link. Right. Do you already have one?
I need a link. That's the link. All right, I'm ready.
So, audio listeners, I am sorry, but we're going to watch this trailer. It's going to be dope. It's going to be awesome. So, you can pretty... I'm sure that you guys who watch this have seen the trailer, and if not... you can pretty much tell what's going on mostly through audio, so.
Yeah.
All right. 3, 2, 1, play. Gives me a good chance to drink water while we watch this.
It's true.
Today is a day for truth. The world needs to know what happened and to know what he stands for.
I've watched so many.
Power is very dangerous.
I've watched so many like rewind theaters and like analysis of this. It's so awesome.
Let the record show that this committee holds him responsible.
That's how it starts. The fever. The rage.
Ben Affleck is ripped, by the way. Yeah. He's freaking jacked.
Cruel.
This bat vigilante is like a one-man reign of terror.
God.
You don't get to decide what the right thing is. Nobody cares about Clark Kent taking on the Batman.
This means something. It's all some people have. It's all that gives them hope.
People hate what they don't understand. Be their hero, Clark. Be their angel. Be their monument. Be anything they need you to be. Or be none of it. You don't owe this world a thing. You never did.
Do you know the oldest lie in America, Senator?
The devils don't come from hell beneath us.
They come from the sky.
20 years in Gotham.
I love this so much. There's so many awesome details in here.
He has the power to wipe out the entire human race.
See, I still want to see what's driving Batman to do this.
It's pretty, it's a little bit of it is shown in this trailer as like some details that I can show you in a minute.
I mean, I saw the details. One of Wayne's buildings was destroyed.
Yeah. Employees killed? That's messed up.
You're gonna go to war.
This part is trippy.
He is not our enemy.
Black and blue.
These action
God
scenes.
God versus man.
That right there is night. So dope.
I'm interested what scene. I'm interested what kind of arsenal that he has.
Thank you. good. And so much of this is
not
so
gonna be out
good.
For another what year?
Yeah, freaking 2016. God.
Oh, oh it's goodness. March 25th, so it's not too bad, so but still. Good.
Yeah, it's 2016. The first bit. Dude, fall of 2015 until summer of 2016 is gonna be freaking legit, because we got all these fall games, and then we have all the spring games that were kind of pushed. See, freaking Doom, Uncharted, Batman v Superman. It's gonna be awesome. Oh, there was so many good details in here. Like, okay, we'll do a quick analysis. Freaking Superman showing up for a court hearing, which I think is awesome. Like, this shows there are, like, some people are like, is Superman gonna be a bad guy in this movie? There's no way.
Yeah.
Because Superman, if he shows up, I love how no security guards are even trying to, like, escort. You know, like, right. If somebody shows up to a hearing, there's, like, a
They're
security guard,
try.
Like, pushing
why would
him.
They even try?
So. Yeah, there's, like, a security guard pushing them towards the front or, like, leading them there, holding his shoulder or something. And then, they'll, like, get to the stand, and then they'll walk back. But Superman just waltz in the room, like, by himself. All the guards are just, like, watching, and he's just walking in. Like, nobody's touching him. Because, I mean, you don't want to. But, basically, then they go into the Zod and Superman fight, which is awesome, because one of the biggest criticisms of Man of Steel is the giant fight where, you know, everyone's like, there are so many people dying through this. They're just murdering buildings and everything. So it shows Bruce Wayne, who was apparently there, Ben Affleck as Bruce Wayne. And you see, I saw somebody on Reddit do a comparison to that one shot where Bruce is looking at it. And then they did a comparison to Zod doing the exact movements with his heat vision. And it was like the exact parallel. Everywhere. It's so good. But, yeah. And then, you know, Bruce Wayne. This is an awesome shot. Bruce Wayne running into the smoke, like, with no hesitation. Everyone else is running out, afraid, and he's running in with, like, no hesitation. So, right there, there's a... What?
He dies, and then game over. Freaking movie's over.
Yeah, just a fall. Yeah, I thought that too. I was like, "That's boss." But realistically, I was like, "What if one thing just falls and crushes?" But just one thing. But yeah, so in that shot right there, you see the Wayne Tower sign. Which
yeah,
is,
that's where I was saw. I saw the Wayne Tower sign.
Yeah.
I was like, oh.
And later on that newspaper, when he's looking, it says Wayne Tower demolished, dozens killed. So yeah, one of his motivations is that it's slightly personal, like people he knew, maybe a theory, I really hope it's not true, but a theory is that like Dick Grayson was in the building or something like that. And it's just really personal now, which,
yeah,
but I don't think that theory is true. Cause if it's Nightwing, Nightwing's going to freaking get out of the building. Like he's
right.
He's not gonna be in there. So yeah, he's training here. This is Alfred talking about how basically he's letting. This is an older, more grizzled Batman who's been through years, and he's like just witnessed a tragedy. Like he's not thinking straight. You know what I mean? That's what Alfred's saying. Right. Like your emotions are turning you into something that you don't want to be. Which also, I want to point out, this Alfred looks like a freaking boss. This is not like an old, frail butler Alfred. He doesn't even look that old. He doesn't even look that much older than Ben Affleck.
I think the actual actor, who is this guy anyway?
I heard
he looks
his
like
name
freaking
one, but I don't know.
RDJ.
But yeah, he does not look like that much older than Ben Affleck. He looks like a fairly young Alfred, which I don't know. It looks cool. I'm down with it. It's different. And then you get to the part where they're talking about the Bat Vigilante, and there is a bat symbol branded into a thug. Just want to toss that out there. Moving on. Clark Kent was trying to research Batman. I gotta move.
You know, the casual glasses.
Yeah.
So,
All right. Weird thing. Oh, here's you know, the image of Superman, like, you know, the angelic image that they're trying to shoot him as. The weird thing about this was Ma Kent just being freaking ruthless. She's like, you could be a hero, you could be a god to them, or you could just let him die. I mean, you don't really owe him anything.
Yeah.
I was like, dang, son. But yeah, moving on. Lex Luthor. Jesse Eisenberg is Lex Luthor talking to the senator lady that we saw at the beginning, trying to, you know, manipulate politics as Lex Luthor does. Zod in a body bag. Are we seeing
cloning?
Cadmus?
Superboy? I can't take Lex Luthor seriously because that actor has been in so many comedies.
That wig just kills me. I really don't like the wig. It doesn't look good. Like, that's the only thing. It just doesn't look good. This shot right here, joke's on you, Batman, on an old Robin suit. That is Jason Todd's Robin suit. So in this universe, Jason Todd is dead. That's dope. Moving on. Superman, these soldiers have, like, a Superman symbol on their shoulder. So, I feel like Superman's, maybe they're trying to carry out justice in his name or something, but they're killing, and Superman's coming to be like, hey, don't do that. Yeah. It's Batman in his mech suit, turning on the bat symbol. Don't know why he has to call himself, but why not? It's pretty cool. And then you get some awesome action shots. Here's the origin, Thomas Wayne dying, like, for the billionth time. Mm-hmm. Lois Lane, Bruce Wayne, Gal Gadot as Wonder Woman. You see a shot of her getting into a limo or a fancy car, like, not as Wonder Woman. Then you see an action shot of her, which is weird. Her bracers normally just, like, deflect bullets, and in this shot, she just smashes her two bracers together and make, like, a giant EMP explosion. I don't know what's going on there, but it sounds interesting.
Weird stuff going on.
Yeah, and then you go to, like, a freaking Afghanistan looking place with Batman with goggles and, like, a jacket. I don't know what's going on here. And he freaking just snaps a neck of this Superman soldier nonchalantly. So I feel like that might be, like, a dream sequence, you know, where Batman's thinking of, like, oh, what could have happened if this?
Yeah.
Maybe. Then you see just a freaking. This is an. This, like, 2 seconds where Batman just, you know, does, like, a 1-2 to these two guys, and he moves like you would imagine Batman moves in The Dark Knight Returns, where he's old, he's, like, his whole design is that he's a fat Batman, like, he's big, he's beefy, and he moves slower, but hits harder, you know what I mean? Like, this is perfect, and it's so much different than any other Batman we've seen in live action. Like, every other Batman we've seen is, like, normal Batman. This is, like, a good, different interpretation of it. Lex Luthor looking at Kryptonite. Batman, you know, this is some actual action shots. He jumped on Superman mech suit and fell through the roof. Wonder Woman getting hit. Superman flying. Shooting the heat vision. This right here, where Batman is, like, hanging from I don't know what that is, like a pipe, and then he grapples away. It looks awesome, especially with the lightning in the background. That looks freaking great.
Yeah. You know, it kind of reminds me of your Skype picture.
It very much is. Like, it. I don't know. I love my Skype picture. For anyone who doesn't know, it's from the Court of Owls where Batman's, like, patrolling, and yeah, it's a pretty famous, like, image.
It's funny because it actually looks exactly like it because he's using his left hand to use the grapple.
Nah, dude, you know. Here, let me.
Oh my gosh.
There's a. Not really. There's a parallel to The Dark Knight Returns that is, like.
Yeah.
Like, almost spot on. Like, it's the cover of The Dark Knight Returns and it looks almost exactly like that. If I can find the picture, I'll show you, but I don't know if I can. Yeah, and then Superman ripping for the last thing. Superman ripping the doors off of the Batmobile, and Ben Affleck standing up and just not giving any craps whatsoever. I love that last shot. All right, spent too long on that, but gosh dang, it was good. Suicide Squad trailer.
Suicide Squid.
They actually, originally it leaked, and then they released the HD like they should have in the first place. And I don't know. Eric liked it. Andrew really liked it. It was a good trailer. I don't know. It didn't do anything to me. I thought that I would have more impressions on the whole thing and Jared Leto and all that after that, but I didn't. I was just sort of like, jury's still out. That didn't affect me at all. I don't know. I wasn't like, Jared Leto's so good or anything like that. I don't know. I don't know why, but it didn't. So, yeah. Quick mention about... I have not watched this, but IGN, their first for the month is No Man's Sky. So one of the things they did is release an 18-minute long, no interruptions, No Man's Sky gameplay of just going around the world and doing stuff. So I really want to watch that. I just want to say check that out because I'm sure that's really cool and you get to see what that game's actually about more than anything because I really want to know. I'm like going through all this. You want to cover some stuff real quick? I'm just trying to fly through.
I don't know. What's going on over at Konami?
It's the... Do you not know me?
I know.
Oh, okay, yeah. It's something. That is a question, though. As to what is going
freaking,
on.
Freaking... It kind of bothers me because I've become a recent fan of Hideo Kojima's work.
Kojima. So. Gosh dang it.
Said it a thousand different ways, Kojima. Hideo Kojima. And they removed his name from the Metal Gear Solid 5 box art, which is absurd because I am pretty sure he has worked on at least 70% of that game.
Yeah, it's very odd. Like, I was listening to Unlocked and they were talking about how like maybe he did something awful, and like politically in the business, he did something awful. But like, Konami is doing everything in their power to make him look like the good guy. Like, he looks like the one that is in the right here. So, and they look like the bad guys, like taking his name off. So, maybe he did something awful. Maybe he just screwed over somebody high up at the company. But like,
no, I think
even
it's
so, they're not
going
about
on
it,
over
right?
here at Konami because. Hideo has been wanting to stop making Metal Gear Solid games since like the third one or something.
Yeah.
So
I don't know, man.
I feel like they were forcing him into some sort of contract and he got pissed off or something.
And maybe he then purposefully screwed over people, was like, maybe. Revenge. But I don't know.
So
I don't know, but it's, I want to know what's going on over there, because that story is interesting. Whatever.
Yeah. So yeah, I don't know what's going on there, but
yeah,
I was really excited to see his work with Silent Hills.
Yeah, that's a bummer. That's going. Oh my gosh, the mosquito thing's on my monitor. He's back.
He's back. He's back.
Oh my god. All right. Windows 10 is happening in 10 days, Eric. 10 days, legitimately. Dude. Windows 10 is happening. I saw this article on Polygon that was talking about Xbox One streaming to Windows 10 is working now. Like, for people who have Windows 10 early, it's available and working.
So, when you get Windows 10, you can play Halo on your PC.
I could, if I wanted to do such a thing.
It's amazing.
But, to be honest, this is for people who have a living room set up and then have a PC in another room. Like, mine is all right here. Like, it's for if I had my Xbox over there.
What
and
if
I wanted
you don't
to play
want
to
use,
desk.
I mean, can you use mouse and keyboard?
Maybe. I don't know. It's a good question. But I just want to remind people that Xbox One is, or Windows 10 is 10 days away. July 29th. So be ready for that.
That's funny because it's 10 days away and it's Windows 10.
we're the best.
From what I've seen of Windows 10, it looks awesome.
I've never been excited for an OS, but I am right now.
Yeah.
Like, just, I don't know. They have a lot of, like, gaming features with it. Like, they're supporting, like, Xbox Live on a PC. Like, that's cool.
Yeah. Could we just get Halo One Piece now?
Big. Actually, I got some stuff that isn't on the Google Doc that I just found real quick, Eric. So let me go over this real quick. Goat Simulator is coming to the PS4 on August 11th. So I'm excited about that because it's been on the Xbox forever. But August 11th, Goat Simulator. Wreck crap up as a goat. Just saying. They had this guy. His name is Sid Schumann. He wrote an article on the PlayStation blog talking about his hands-on experience with Uncharted the Nathan Drake Collection. He got to play the helicopter scene from Uncharted 2. And he was talking about how everything, it's like a really good frame rate and it's 1080p and they like redid resolution. But his best thing that he was saying was like they redid resolutions and textures enough to make it modern, but they still wanted to keep Naughty Dog's original creative artistic direction. Yeah. Which is awesome because, like, Uncharted 2 has a really good style. So, I don't know. I'm really excited for that. But one of the biggest things in here was, let's see. Also, yeah, we found out this. This was pretty much assumed, but the motion controls for the grenade in Uncharted 1, they're getting rid of that, which is great. This is the highlight of this article. You'll get to, though my experiences with the game were brief, they were encouraging. You'll get to see for yourself when a playable demo launches on the PlayStation Store later this summer.
Sweet.
So yeah, playable demo, PlayStation Store, this summer.
Speaking
which is awesome.
Of demos, Street Fighter V is on. It's gonna be a demo.
You sounded so dead for a second there. I was like, dang, bro. Yeah, you're I don't know, you're, it's a bummer, but
Street Fighter 5
dude. You're like
demo.
Speaking of demos,
I was trying to like formulate a sentence, you know,
like, yeah, I don't know, it's a bummer. I it's so crazy that your sickness came back like a week later.
Yeah.
Like just it was like hiding in the shadows. It was like, ha! You thought you were good, didn't you?
Now.
Yeah.
Right back.
But yeah, that apparently is having a demo. Do you know like when or?
Yes, I do.
Oh, all right then.
The 23rd.
Okay.
I might be reading ahead in the drop.
Okay.
I was looking
at
demos and betas.
I see. Yeah, Street Fighter V, exclusive beta. I wonder if that's open or closed. It's a good question. Speaking, quick thing that is also not on the doc. The Rainbow Six Siege, their closed beta is like beginning really soon, and you can sign up now.
I signed up for that.
Yeah, so did I. Somebody at work told me that it was beginning, and I was like, I don't think it's beginning. But then again, it could just like happen. You never know. And it's a closed beta, so it might not be on the drop, and it might just come out on Tuesday, and like we didn't know. This mosquito thing is right here and will not get off my desk. I don't want to smash him onto my desk, but like, get the crap out of here, dude. All right. So, Eric, let me make sure that's it. Nope. Big thing.
Yeah.
Big thing.
Say
freaking crap. And then we got, after this one big thing. Then I want to go over two drops because we missed a drop and I pulled it up. And I also want to go over the PS Plus games for July.
Well, you can go over the old drop. I'll do the new drop, but we'll do this stuff. This thing, right?
Destiny. Their weekly update consisted of one article and then another article that was a giant thing.
Can you click their blogs?
Oh, my bad. Oh. It consisted of one blog and then another blog.
yes.
One of them was just the regular weekly
like
update
overview.
With the movie thing and whatnot. And then another thing was the...
like a list of updates for weapon tuning.
Yeah, another was the sandbox designer. One of the sandbox designers talking like in detail about their goals for each thing and their changes exactly to what they're doing. And what the biggest thing was, like, most of this sounded either complete or really close to complete, but you know, not launching until September, so we got all these details about this weapon balancing we gotta wait 2 more months for. But ARs are gonna be usable again. Yeah, the highlights are ARs hopefully will be usable again.
Yeah,
Thorns getting a pretty hardcore nerf.
Pulse rifles are getting nerfed, which is...
Only slightly, though, it looked like.
Yeah, I thought about that. But then I was listening to that other podcast. And
Planet Destiny podcast.
I agreed with them. They didn't like the idea of it. And a three-shot burst with...
Yeah, that Red does Death sound like a little bit much. That does sound like a little bit much. But at the same time, pulse rifles are pretty dang strong with that now. Yeah. Pretty dang strong.
I mean, well, here's the thing. The only, like great pulse rifles is, like, Red Death.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like some of the legendaries need some buffs.
The Messenger is ridiculous.
The Messenger is pretty good. It still takes a lot of skill to use, honestly.
I wonder if Praetorian Foil is any good in PvP.
It is. It's pretty much Messenger. I bet it's pretty good. Yeah. It's baby Messenger. Scout rifles are getting it's getting a PvE buff by 5%, which is
yeah, cool. I like that.
That's fine.
Most of these I like, by the way. Yeah. I'm just gonna toss that out there. Most of these I think are
the only one I don't like is fusion rifles because they're making them even worse than they already are right now and useless.
My only thing that I don't like is Icebreaker. I think that's pretty dumb.
Yeah. I kind of agree too, but I have listened to one good reason and I can agree with it. I think I said it the other day to you, but it was because we use Icebreaker as a primary. We just sit there and wait for it to recharge and recharge and recharge.
Yeah, to be honest,
you're supposed to like shoot it, switch back to your primary,
but
and continue shooting.
To be honest, I don't do that. Like I use, like, at least for the Devil Walker fight, I use my Icebreaker and I use a Vision. And when I don't have Icebreaker ammo, I'm shooting with my Vision.
You must be in the minority then, but yeah, that's how it's supposed to be used. But
yeah, well, then again, it's probably going to make...
Though.
Yeah, I don't know. So, Icebreaker is getting they're changing the time for a bullet to spawn back in from 5 seconds to 8. So, it makes it a little bit longer to wait, but I don't know. Black Hammer, I'm just going over, big things that are sticking out in my head. Black Hammer takes ammo from your reserve, which is interesting, instead of just, infinite ammo. Galhorn is also getting a nerf, which is crazy. But the only thing that they said was Wolfpack rounds damage will be decreased. So I don't think it'll be that big of a deal.
Yeah, I mean, it's still going to be the best rocket. It's just not going to be as good as it once was.
Unless something from the Taken King comes out and wrecks everything.
Oh, yeah. I feel like there will be more Wolfpack or different types of... perks that are similar to Wolfpack, as in they do extra damage upon the initial impact,
Yeah. So. Dude, I'm so hyped for the Taken King. After listening to a bunch of Planet Destiny, I'm so excited. There's a lot of cool stuff. And the subclasses alone?
Yeah. This also makes me think, I feel like some of these changes that they're doing here are for the meta that they know in the Taken King.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah, the thing is,
they're
probably
thinking ahead.
Destiny has been this same, meta, I guess you can say, for, five months now.
It switched from Suros to Thorn.
Yeah, but, it's been the same for, 5 months now. And House of Wolves, with House of Wolves dropping, it's basically been... Destiny, in general, has pretty much been the same for about 2 months, you know what I mean? So, I'm looking forward to different stuff, to trying different weapons, to new things. To be honest, House of Wolves was good, but a lot of the weapons are really lackluster. I don't care about my Wolf Slayer's Claw. I don't... Prison of Elders was really lackluster, in general. I like Prison decently, but it's not what they promised.
I feel like it was needed, though, to give us options.
Yeah. Yeah,
if you get tired of raiding and you just want to do some horde-based kind of, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. My only complaint with freaking Prison is that it's not what they promised. Like, they promised replayability and random aspects to, like, all of it. And it's not. Like, if you play Urox 1 week, is the exact... Like, say you play Urox on 32, and then it shows up later on the 34. There's going to be no changes whatsoever other than the level. All the modifiers are going to be the same. All the rooms are going to be the same. Every objective is going to be the same. It's all the same. Like, there's about... four, like, Urox, Quadron, like, all those different ones. There's about four or five of those bosses slash setups.
Yeah.
And then, but once you know those, they don't change. So there's about four or five different horde modes, including Skoloth. And that's it. There's no, other than the level 28, there's no random aspect to it at all.
Yeah.
And that's what they said was going to be there for replayability. So.
I mean, there is, like, different rounds. Every week, I believe.
I'm pretty sure there isn't. I'm pretty sure it's the same objectives too, which is crazy.
I'm not sure.
It's definitely the same modifiers though.
Well,
the same
I know Skolas doesn't change besides some of the modifiers. But
Skolas' modifiers don't even change anymore because the last encounter was the only one where it changed, and now they don't do that anymore because of the nerf. So.
They took off burns because it was just, and they lowered his health by like percent.
I'm honestly excited to try that. I still feel like that fight is too much mechanically. I think that's too much to handle. I think all of it is too much. I think it's just too much on the screen, too much happening. But I'm excited to try it.
I think it was just bad because of the burns. Honestly,
I know, but
burn.
We tried it with Void Burn, and it's still too much. Like, Void Burn, there's, like, barely anything at all, like, shooting you with Void in that.
Yeah,
and, like, it's... I still think it's just too much. But maybe it'll be a lot better after the nerf. We really haven't tried it. But once Ryan gets home, we should try that. And we should also do it with Andrew, but I want to do it with Ryan sometime soon.
Something I wanted to say about... This actually reminded me, because... You play as a 34 in 35 PoE.
Yeah.
But apparently in the Taken King, there's a possibility of our... I mean, I know at, like, E3, those builds that said, like, that it was, like, 50 light level and stuff like that, which I doubt we're going to be 50. I heard it's going to double.
The base level is supposed to be 30, and that's supposedly confirmed from what I've heard, is that the base level is going to be 30. And then after that, we don't fully know.
Because I've heard that it, like, we might go into 40s now.
Yeah. Dude, I'm... Also, one of the main reasons why I'm so excited is that not just the subclasses and all the different updates in the meta, which is awesome, but, like, they seem to be adding a lot. Like, a lot that we don't know about. There's
The new weapon models are...
Beautiful. What's cool is that there's, like, Suros of, like, different weapon classes.
It's like Borderlands.
Yeah, freaking... Like Borderlands. You get a Suros pulse rifle that is... Oh, dude.
Suros rocket?
Heck yes.
That Suros rocket looks
so
really
down
cool.
For this. This is gonna be awesome.
Also, the company, whoever makes the hard light, also has some guns too that look really cool.
That's awesome.
If you go watch,
because Hardlight is aesthetically one of my favorite.
Dude, yeah,
guns.
they made other guns that look really cool. When you go watch, the newest podcast of the things, they show a Hardlight. It's like the Hardlight company. I'm not sure what the company's called. It's somewhere in the lore, but the gun, it's like a bunch of beams and lasers, of course.
Yeah,
lasers.
I wonder if they all have the projectile thing, like the ricochet. Probably not, but...
Maybe, but the sight was... it would highlight targets in a white film, so you could see the...
that's cool.
And it was a scout rifle, so you could get position.
Oh, that's really cool. I'm down with that.
I
want
feel
that
like
scout
that
rifle.
Very useful
I
for
want that.
Big maps.
Dude, this makes me want to play Destiny more. We again, remember, I don't have my vault armor for my Titan, and I really want it. So we should get on.
I need to run Volt for Gallimore.
Yeah, you really should. We should get on and just freaking. You know how long it's been since we run Vault of Glass? Vault of Glass is the best.
Yes, it is.
And once, oh, dude.
We're going to run it with Gabby.
Yeah, I'm so excited to get Gabby and Jared up to speed, because once they get to freaking do Vault of Glass, we can do it with them. It's going to be so good. I'm so excited.
Crota.
I'm so excited. Oh, dude, we would need to go back and do Crota as level 34s. We need to. I've been hearing stories about, like how good you do as a 34, and I'm just like, oh, I need to try this out.
A hard mode?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. It needs that.
Before the shotguns get nerfed.
Oh, yeah. Freaking. We also need to have one person just... I know on normal mode you one-shot the Death Singer with Celestial Nighthawk, but I don't know about on hard. So we need to have two people. Yeah, but just in case, we need to have two people go in.
Oh, yeah.
Just...
with...
dude, I'm so excited. And so awesome. I don't... And I have my Nighthawk now. Like, I want to... Like, legitimately, I'm getting sort of back into this. I want to get on and, like, do bounties so I can level up, like,
my armors. I actually did some bounties with Jared, so I was like, awesome. Hey.
Yeah, you're like, yeah, stacking up. Dude, what I heard, they should go get Red Bull from 7-Eleven. That's what I'm saying.
We don't have a 7-Eleven.
Yeah, that's a bummer. But, like, apparently somebody leveled up from, like, nothing. Like, instantly, like, they packed up from, like, 8 to 20. Because they use the
double. Do you have a 7-Eleven around?
No, I don't. I wish I did. That's the freaking problem. Like, if it was Red Bull, I'd be okay. But why specifically Red Bull, specifically at 7-Eleven? Like, there's no 7-Elevens nearby.
I went to the Kroger where I live, and I went to the freaking energy drink section.
Yeah, and you started looking around.
I looked around for it, and I was looking. I even asked... Where's the destiny? Where's That's my funny. Destiny?
Where then, is my destiny? Tell me, Clark.
And then, well, what ended up happening? I just got like a small Red Bull just for the heck of it. But
like, I came here for a Red Bull.
I came here for a code.
That's a bummer.
So yeah, and we don't have any. I don't know. Maybe I can pay someone from the Fireteam chat Facebook via Facebook cash.
Yeah, dude, I don't know. I need to be looking out. But that is the weapon balances and weapon rebalances. So I am very excited for that. Me and Eric are getting back into the Destiny. But at the same time, I really want to clear my backlog, and I really want to get caught up in Halo, and I really want to read my comics and watch Girl Meets World. So you can only do so much in this life. So, Eric, the weird thing about poor PlayStation Powerhouse Ryan Clements is that this week's drop is not like the regular drops, where they have like a picture next to them and they have a description. They're just a list this week. So some of these, we're going to have no idea what they are.
Yeah, I saw that, so.
Okay, let's cover... We're getting out of here, for you guys who don't know the drill. We're getting out of here. It's 11:30. Just in case you guys don't know, because it took me forever to reset up back in my room, we started this at, like, 10:30. It's, like, 11:51, so it's almost midnight. So we're going to get out of here. Free games for July. Styx, Master of Shadows for the PS4, which does not look good. Mousecraft for PS4, PS3, and Vita. Entwine for PS4, PS3, and Vita. Rain for PS3. And Geometry Wars 3. Dude, the cool thing about Geometry Wars 3 on the Vita is that it's apparently like 75 megabytes. So it could just stay on your Vita forever, because it's like doesn't take up any size at all. So yeah. I put it on there, and Geometry Wars is like a really, really good twin stick shooter, and I'm a big fan of those, so I'm gonna try that out when I just have a time to sit on my couch. I'm just gonna play that. And then Rocket League for the PS4, which is a game that you need to download and play right now if you own a PS4 and internet, because it's amazing.
Yeah, if anyone misses out on that game, they have problems.
Rocket League is fantastic. It is really good. Eric, I'm thinking of doing this. You know how we were talking about, like, people should have a PS Plus game of the year? I think we should do it ourselves. I'm thinking at the end of the year we should go back because I play almost all.
Wins.
What?
We would know which one wins. I mean,
no, I mean it's still possible. Also, like there was another one that came out earlier.
Free
this year
game
that I really
PS
liked.
Plus free games of the year.
Yeah, free like PS Plus game of the year, where we find like we'll go through back through all the articles. And to be honest, I play almost all of them. Like I usually I'll take a day and I'll just play like 30 minutes.
I play
each,
ones that
and if one
have the most
me,
buzz about them and actually are good.
Well, so. Well, most of them are good. So you
I mean,
should play
Unfinished
all of them.
One was really good.
You should play all of them. I'm just saying, play all of them. Literally, it takes like 20 minutes. Like, if you start a game and you don't like it, you wasted, 5 minutes of your time. You close it and you delete it. You move on. But you
I
never
wasted
know.
5 minutes of my time. There we
but,
go.
But that's not. But it was free. And it was time. Like, that's all you wasted. Like, 5 minutes.
See,
it's not that big of a deal. Otherwise, you could open
Rocket League
it. And it was.
It was going to be great. And it.
But you can download all of them and find a hidden gem, dude. That's what I'm saying. Like, I found one that I can't remember the name of it, but like I spent forever on it because I just opened it and it was a free PS Plus game of the month, and I was like, all right, let's give this a shot because, you know, I'm fair like that and give every game a shot. And then
Unfinished Swan.
It was great. Unfinished Swan is critically acclaimed. That's not a hidden gem. Like you freaking Rain on PS3. That could be great. We don't know. I could try it. Like, I could open it, and I could be like, this isn't my thing. Close it and delete it. Or I could open it and be like, this is awesome. Mm-hmm. I'm glad I spent the time trying this out.
Yeah.
I'm just saying. You could find one of your new favorite games to do this. It's not that big of a deal. They're free. They're literally free. So do it. Especially if you want to freaking do PS Plus game of the year, because that way we're qualified to go over all of them at the end of the year. The drop for July 14th.
I'm doing this.
Yeah,
week.
July 14th, 2015. Which is 2 weeks ago. Arcade Archives Buta San for the PS4. Deceptions 4, The Nightmare Princess for the PS4, PS3, and Vita. EA Sports. Rory McIlroy, PGA Tour, the new Tiger Woods, as they call him. The Fall for PS4. I mean, he legitimately is the new Tiger Woods. He's on the cover of the new EA Sports golf
who?
Game. Rory McIlroy.
Rory
apparently.
McIlroy. Okay.
I mean, like, he's on the EA Sports golfing game cover, so yeah. I guess it's the new Tiger Woods
PGA.
Game. God of War 3 Remastered for PS4 came out. Godzilla for PS4, which is apparently not very good. Monster Jam Battlegrounds for the PS3. Oh, Ryan needs to get on this game. The Vanishing of Ethan Carter for PS4. It came out 2 weeks ago. That game's apparently really, really good. It was up for a bunch of awards last year because it was on PC last year. So if you're into first person, they're called FPS.
First person killers.
Wow. That's brutal. Those person killers. Are you like serial killer?
Basically what Halo is.
That's pretty much what every first person shooter is. Yeah. But
it's with FPS. Is.
I was thinking first person exploration games. That's they're a whole new thing. They're a whole new genre. They're called FPX.
Basically
FPXs.
Ether 1 or Unfinished 1.
Yeah. It is one of those, and it's kind of like a mystery. And it's
those
apparently
are really cool. I mean, they're just chill. They usually have good music.
It apparently has a really, really good story, The Vanishing of Ethan Carter.
What is it called?
The Vanishing of Ethan Carter. It was huge on PC, like huge.
I've heard of it.
So, yeah. And that is it for 2 weeks ago. And now, you have a good. Some of these games, you have freaking no idea. But there's one on here that if you haven't played it, you need to. No spoilers, but just saying.
What?
You'll see. You know what I'm talking about.
What list? Is it my list?
Yeah, on your list.
Okay. All right. Arcade Archives Mag Max PS4 Digital. Obviously, gotta have your.
Yeah, it always starts off with the Arcade Archive.
Gotta have those arcade games. F1 2015. I have no idea what that is,
and it doesn't give a description. PlayStation powerhouse fraud Ryan. No, I'm just kidding.
Fraud Ryan. No, Clements, that's the title.
No, you're a bro, Ryan Clements. You're the best.
Okay, had a full boyfriend,
is the pigeon dating simulator. The pigeon dating simulator. That's for PS4.
I've seen some YouTubers play this, and it is the weirdest freaking. It's
really weird.
Japan. I don't know what you're doing, but apparently you're doing it right for the YouTubers. So.
It's something.
Anyway, the game. I was gonna have a whole fanfare, be like the critically acclaimed. The blah, blah, blah. No, it's Journey.
Journey.
It's good.
If you have not played Journey or haven't seen anybody play Journey or anything, if you are not familiar with Journey and you're a PlayStation 4 gamer, play that immediately. That is all.
I would say watch it, but no. It's an experience.
Do not do that. It's
the much PlayStation experience. Oh.
Oh, coming in December.
Anyway, okay, next on our list here. Oh, yeah, that's going to be PS4 cross-buy with PS3.
So. Oh, yeah, so I have that because I played it on PS3. Yes. That's cool.
Which is cool.
I like cross-buy.
New Nutjutsu.
Nutjutsu.
I was trying to, put the syllables together, and I was like, nut. Jitsu, okay.
Nutjutsu.
So yeah, Nutjutsu. PS4 digital.
Swinging around with their nuts.
Yep.
maybe. Swinging around with their nuts. Gosh, dang it.
What? Onichabara.
One Chanbara, maybe.
No, it's foreign name, yeah. So it's Onichabara. Onichabara.
Z2K.
It's for digital retail. It's a retail game, which is really weird.
Yeah. You're going to go into GameStop and pick that one up.
Hey, can you point out Onichabara?
Z2 Chaos.
Chaos.
Yeah, sure. It's right over here.
Sure. It's right over here in the back of the store. In the
let me go pick it out from the closet.
Okay. Poltergeist. A pixelated horror. And now...
Crossbuy with the Vita, PS4, awesome.
Yeah, crossbuy with Vita.
Big fan of those.
This is kind of weird because I'm not sure what this has to do with Poltergeist. Is this Poltergeist the game itself, or is this based upon the movie from the 80s or 70s? I can't remember.
That's a good question.
Because I don't know. I don't have a picture. I don't have a description.
Fraud, Ryan Klonowski.
Yeah. So next is Cube, Q-U-B-E, Cube.
In all directors. Caps and periods, yeah. In between each letter.
When it is called Cube, C-U-B-E, it makes the world easier. what if you have to search this up on PSN?
You have to type in each dot. That would suck.
Anyway, Cube, Director's Cup. Cup.
The cup from the director himself reaches out from the PlayStation Store and gives you a cup. Here you go.
It comes in the mail. Yeah.
Gosh dang it.
Yeah, PS4, PS3, digital crossbuy. That's cool. No idea what it is.
Yeah.
I'm guessing it's about cubes.
Maybe. Maybe it's about a cup.
The next game. It's called Squares.
For the Vita. I think Eric's losing it. Eric's losing it. He has no idea what anything is.
I think it's about cubes.
Bringing it back, dude. Holy crap. dude, there's two games on here that are just retail releases, which is interesting.
Yeah, you're right. But wait, really?
Yeah.
I'm surprised Wolfenstein. Okay, next is Wolfenstein the Old Blood. I actually have that on Steam. I need to play it. Wolfenstein, the original game, is really good. But this is the DLC. It's like a prequel DLC.
Well, yeah, DLC doesn't... I mean, it doesn't usually come out on retail until later.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes it will, but...
Yeah, this is a standalone DLC. That's what the Old Blood is. So apparently it's really good. So. So yeah, there's that. Wolfenstein, Old Blood. Great, great game. Next, here we got Yasai Ninja, on PS4 digital. Probably Ninja, probably slash stuff up.
Probably doing thank stuff, Ryan throwing Clement. Ninja stuff.
Last here we have Zombie Army Trilogy.
That's the Nazi Zombie Sniper Elite series for retail.
Ah, yeah, nice.
And then, as you were saying, you got that Street Fighter V beta starting on July 3rd.
I mean, and if you care, Lynyrd Skynyrd is going to be on PlayStation Music.
Oh my gosh! I've been waiting for this.
My dad listened to Lynyrd Skynyrd, so
I've been waiting for this my entire life, dude. The Divergent series Insurgent is coming to
Oh my gosh. Yeah.
Apparently, you know what's weird is that Divergent is based off of like three books. I'm pretty sure three. Like the similar to the Hunger Games, but the second movie was apparently awful. Like the first movie was great and the second one was apparently just crap, which is so weird cuz like the Hunger Games, once you have it going, you got a style similar to Harry Potter and whatnot. You know what you're doing. You got the tone, but I don't know what they did there. So, yeah. But I haven't seen any of them or read the books, so I don't know too much about that.
When does Ryan Clements post these?
Sundays. It's like okay, Sunday mornings.
Maybe
afternoons.
It's because maybe we're not seeing descriptions because he hasn't gotten there yet.
No, it's just I don't know. He's just maybe.
I mean,
on the last one. I don't know, maybe he just didn't have time or something. Hey, man, he's got important meetings to go to.
Yeah.
He's got a...
Powerhouse stuff.
He's got tons of PlayStation things to do, you know what I'm saying?
He should hire an intern.
And one of them could be named Teddy. Or Eric, most likely. Teddy. Just tossing that out there. Just saying.
Okay.
All right, well, that is it. Do you have... I mean, I got random crap to show you. I got a poster over here that counts. Is just a water hose turning off? I don't...
do you got something? I'll look for something.
Posters! Boom, baby!
Oh, yeah, your posters.
Look at them. They're beautiful. Let me go take them off the wall and bring them over here. No, I'm not doing it. Dude, it took us forever. We had to, like, level it. Because, you know, they'd be... If one of them was, like, slightly crooked, that'd be awful. We used a leveler. They're fancy like that.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
I don't have anything fancy, but I do have... my sandal.
Sandal.
It's very useful for walking when you don't feel like putting shoes on.
Or
when you go to McDonald's to get a double cheeseburger.
Dude, that's what I used to do in the summer, but with flip-flops. And did you know this? I went to church one day, and I put on, like, you know, like, white or khaki shorts or something, and then, like, just t-shirt and flip-flops. And threw them on and went out the door. You know, perfectly normal freaking outfit. I don't know. And then I was at church, and, like, somebody was like, he's wearing flip-flops. And they were, like, laughing at me. I'm what? Like, what the freaking
why?
Crap?
I mean, when that's is this? A pretty
but,
casual...
But apparently, I don't know if this is still a thing, but it was apparently a thing, like a fashion thing, that guys are not supposed to wear flip-flops anymore. Like, it's not okay.
No, that's not a thing.
It was there to them.
That's dumb. Then.
To
they're
them
dumb.
It was. And I was like... When did this happen? No one informed me of this.
Sandals are just sandals. I see men in the 30s normally walking around. My dad wears sandals. This is dumb. They're dumb.
I thought that was funny. I was like, nobody told me this. I was just going to wear flip-flops the rest of my life.
Also, I've been saving this fortune cookie. Yes. So today's lucky number, if you feel like being lucky today, is 23. There you go. If you 23, there you
How
go.
How awesome would that have been if that was number, if it was 30, the number of the podcast? That would have been dope.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, well. It's 30 and 23.
There's no 30 on here. There's like a whole list of them, so I'll probably just again.
All right. Well, go out. You know, use the number 23 and
wear sandals.
And wear sandals. And that is all.